Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Math School. As you all know, on this channel I upload videos of class 10th insert math. Also, I have not been uploading videos on my channel since long, so apologies to all my subscribers. So today let us begin from where we had stopped, that is question number 7 from exercise 4.2, chapter 4, circles. Also, I have completed videos on all the other important chapters such as arithmetic progression, triangles, pair of linear equations, quadratic equations, coordinate geometry, trigonometry, and some applications of trigonometry as well. So you can find the link for all these chapters in the description box below. So if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, click the subscribe button, like my video, and also don't forget to hit the bell button below so that you will be notified with all the latest videos on my channel. So now quickly let us begin with the video. Question number 7 from exercise 4.2, chapter 7, circles, which says two concentric circles are of radii 5 cm and 3 cm. Find the length of the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. So here, first of all, let us know what are concentric circles. Any number of circles which have same radii are called as concentric circles. So for example, see here, when we have a circle with center as O, so with this center O, we can have n number of circles, right? So let us draw another two circles with the same center as O. So such circles which have same center are called as concentric circles, right? So this smaller circle might be of radii 2 cm. The second circle must have the radii of 4 cm. And the third circle will have a radii of 6 cm. Okay, the radius will change, but the center remains the same. So such kind of circles are called as concentric circles. Right, so here they are saying us there are two concentric circles with different radii, that is 5 cm radii and a 3 cm radii. Okay, so let us first draw the figure according to the given question. So here let us draw a smaller circle with center O and its radius will be 3 cm. So let us name this circle as C1. Now draw another circle with the same center O with radius 5 cm. So let us name this circle as C2. Coming to the second part of the question, which says find the length of the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. So what is a chord? A line drawn inside a circle which does not pass through the center. So we will draw a chord to the larger circle C2, which is touching the smaller circle at point P. Okay, so let us name this chord as AB. In this manner, we have to draw the chord to the larger circle, which is touching the smaller circle at point P. And here, we have to find out length of this chord AB. Okay, this is what is given in the question we have drawn. Now, accordingly, we will draw the radius. So the radius of the smaller circle is 3 cm, right? That is the line drawn from the center to the circle. So this is the radii of the smaller circle, which is 3 cm. Okay, also we know that this chord AB is acting like a tangent to a smaller circle C1, right? So any tangent at a point of a circle is perpendicular to the radii. So this is radii is OP and AB is a tangent to the smaller circle. Therefore, a 90 degree angle is formed on both the sides of this radii, right? So this is according to our theorem 4.1. Now let us take the radii of the larger circle. Now radius of the larger circle is given as 5 cm. So from the center to point A gives us the radii of the larger circle, right, which is 5 cm. Similarly, we can also draw a radii on the right hand side, that is, we can join OB, which is also the radii of the larger circle, which is 5 cm. Okay, so here we can see that two right angle triangles are formed, that is AOP and BOP, where we know two sides in this right angle triangle and we can easily find out the third side. By applying the Pythagoras theorem, we will get the side AP and BP, so which gives us the length of the chord AB. So now let us first write down, let two concentric circles be C1 and C2 with center as O. And let AB be the chord of the larger circle C2, which touches the smaller circle C1 at P. So we have to describe the figure what we have drawn. So therefore, length of the chord AB can be written as AB is equal to AP plus PB, right? AB is equal to AP plus PB, which gives us the length of the chord. Also, you can write down OP is radii of smaller circle C1, and OA and OB is radii of circle C2. Radii of smaller circle is 3 cm and radii of larger circle C2 is 5 cm. Right? Now, since AB is a tangent of the smaller circle C1, therefore we can say that the radii OP is perpendicular to AB. Right? Since AB is tangent to circle C1, OP is perpendicular to AB by theorem 4.1, which says that tangent at any point P of circle is perpendicular to the radii through the point of contact. So this you have to write down the complete statement so that you will get full marks. So therefore we can write, hence triangle OAP and triangle OBP are right angle triangles. Okay, so therefore triangle OAP and triangle OBP are right angle triangles. Okay, so therefore here we can apply the Pythagoras theorem since they are right angle triangles. So therefore, using Pythagoras theorem, we can say that hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. So in triangle OAP, OA square is equal to the perpendicular square plus the base square, which is OP square, plus base will be AP square. So here we know OA and OP value, which is 5 square and 3 square. OA is 5 square equal to OP is 3 square plus AP square, or AP square is equal to 5 square is 25 minus 3 square is 9, which is equal to 16, or AP is equal to square root of 16, which is equal to 4 centimeter. Okay, so here we got the value of AP. Similarly, if you apply in triangle OBP, okay, triangle OBP, we have hypotenuse is OB. So OB square is equal to OP square plus the base is PB square. Okay, here OB is again 5. So it is 5 square is equal to OP square is 3 square plus PB square, or PB square is equal to 5 square is 25 minus 3 square is 9, which is again equal to 16, or PB is equal to square root of 16, which is equal to 4 centimeter, right? So the length of chord AB, length of chord is equal to AB, which is equal to AP plus PB, right? So here AP is how much? It is 4, plus PB is also 4. So AB is equal to 4 plus 4, it is 8 centimeter, which is the length of chord. So right, so the length of chord is equal to 8 centimeter. This is how we solve this question number 7. If you have any further doubts, you can comment me below in the comment section. In my next video, I'll be solving question number 8 from the same chapter, from exercise 4.2. You can also watch the related videos of this chapter 4 circles shown on the screen. And also don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel for more such videos for you guys. Thank you.